welcoming Governor Justice.
Well, first of all, you know, this beautiful lady that you have, that looks over you every day and does incredible work, father and back, so many different people are making you go and molding you in a lot of ways in who you are. You know, I ran into one or two of your teachers outside. You know, it's a special, special day. But let me just say a couple stories real quick. And you know, I don't have any notes. I just speak to you from my heart. And I would tell you, a guy told me a long time ago, he's the athletic director at Green Mountain East. He said, kids know if you like them. And I hope to goodness that you'll know that I don't not only like you, but I truly mean this when I say I love you. You know, I want so much goodness for you that you can't possibly imagine. I can remember so many different times I've seen your teams. I've had the opportunity to be a coach of a statewide AAU team, and lots of times we practice at your facility, down here and up there. You know, so there's so many, but I can recall this. I see right behind me a state championship in 2019 in soccer. It's amazing, just amazing. And one time, you know, we've had some really great basketball teams at Green Murray's. And one year we had a really good girls team. And our schedule was Charleston Catholic. And so we played you guys at your place. And I knew we'd just beat your brains out, because I knew how good we really were. And what happened was just the opposite. You absolutely just flat-handed it to us right there that night. And it was really a tough night, because I thought, my good Lord, living, these kids are killing us and everything. So you're learning lots and lots of good stuff. But now just stay with me just a second. You know, at the end of the day, it's hard to believe, but my dad would have said to me 1,000 times over, the only thing in your life that cannot be taken away from you is your education. It's hard to believe. And you have so many temptations today, it's off the chart. You know, the drug situation is always standing right there, reaching out to you to see who's going to come next. Who's going to be the victim next? And you've got to be tough. You've got to be tough to stand up against that. You know, I went through a time at Marshall University, a long, long time ago, in the early 1970s, when, you know, if you go back and study when there was the Woodstock concerts and all this kind of stuff, and there was all this hippie-type free love and all going around and everything, and drugs were just prevalent as they could possibly be in a lot of different ways. And you think about this guy. This guy is sitting in front of you. Nobody had more fun in school than me. Nobody. Nobody anywhere. But I can tell you, God above, I can tell you without any question whatsoever, I never, ever, ever have ever tried any type of drug, drink, I don't smoke. I didn't have to do all that. I didn't have to do anything. Now, nobody had more fun. Nobody teased more and had more fun. Because I'm a real believer that the good Lord gives you the ability to smile in life. This week is a really, really special week for the Catholic schools. I think there's 26 of them in West Virginia, and I think we have 4,700 kids in those schools. Do you all know that you have a graduation rate of almost or a little above 99%? It's phenomenal. Would it be hard for you to believe that when I grew up, you know, really and truly, my parents didn't have much of nothing in the beginning. And when I grew up in a little frame house or red cemetery that I played in all the time. My grandparents never had indoor plumbing. Do you think about that? And along the way, I became your governor. I became the guy that owns the Greenbrier Hotel. I became everything that I hope that every single one of you inspired to be. Because this country has given you so much opportunity, it's off the chart. I can tell you just this, though. And I know you believe this. I know you believe it. But I want you to now hear this from a person that came from nothing and ended up with the greatest American dream and story maybe ever. But I can absolutely tell you there is no way that not every step along the way has happened, because that's what God wanted for me to do. He is present in my life every day, over and over and over, and He's present in your life every day. He knows exactly what He wants you to do. And He expects you to try hard. He expects you to work at it. You know, He really was a believer in people working. It's just exactly what you're on your way to do. You could not possibly make people proud. It is an honor beyond belief, and I mean this, because I knew when I said I loved you. Absolutely, it is an honor for me to be with you. You see, every day, and I mean this, every day of my life that I'm the governor, a bunch of the days that are snotty days. I mean, that's all there is to it. Because you've got to do snotty work sometimes. And by that I mean, you absolutely try your hardest, and you're doing what's right, and yet there's always somebody shooting an arrow at you. I'll tell you. And you may not like it, or you may just miss it. I'll tell you without question, this journey is not easy. And you may think today that it's difficult today. It's going to get harder. It's going to get harder. The temptations are going to get bigger. The responsibilities are going to get bigger. The opportunities are going to get bigger. Let me leave you with just this. Here's all there is to it, the way I see it. First and foremost, if I were to say to you, what do you got to do to get better? Now, I can't take everybody's response, but just two or three or four or five of you, just raise your hand and answer me, what do you got to do to get better? And anything you do, what do you got to do? Yes, sir. Okay, work hard.
Do the thing you're trying to get better at over and over.
Be repetitious. Do things over and over. Yes, sir.
Practice.
What were you going to say? What?
Really close.
Learn from your mistakes. Yes, sir. What do you say? Well, I can guess it now.
Try your best.
Try your best. Try your best. Okay. Now, yes, ma'am.
Do you get help others along the way?
What did she say? You get help others along the way? See, that's another thing that's going to happen to you, too. You're not going to be able to hear as well. We've heard a whole lot of stuff. Practice harder, do your best, you know, help others along the way, you know, be more, do repetition, all that kind of stuff. Now here's something I want to make sure that this is the teaching of wisdom that you take with you. How do you get better in this life is truly, truly admitting you're doing something wrong. If you're willing to really do that, you will instantaneously bounce to the betterment beyond belief. I don't care if it's in your sports play, I don't care if it's in your schoolwork, I don't care what it is, you have to admit you're doing something wrong. Think about it. Just think about it. What if I were an alcoholic? You think I'm going to get saved in the church, what do you have to do? Stand up and say, I'm messing up. It is all over your lives and everything. If you're working hard in the gym and your coach is telling you to do something like that and you want to do it another way and you're shooting like this and the coach says shoot like this and you have everything else and you keep shooting like this, you're going to get the same result. But when you, and not just do it for the sake of doing it, when you really believe that you're doing something wrong and you're willing to give into that, the good Lord is standing there. All of us are standing there to know that we're trying to help. You know, my last, and I will tell you is just this. Be this kind of person. And then I'll leave you. I congratulate you in every way for all that you've done and for all the great things the Catholic schools are doing for us in every way, shape, form, or fashion. It is amazing what they are absolutely doing every day. And the teachers and the administrators and all y'all, I love you with all my soul and I thank you from the bottom of my heart. Here's what I will tell you. The count in your life is 3-2. And what I mean by that, now you got to know something about baseball or softball, stay up with me. But your team is in the field, and the other team is bad, and it's the last inning of the game. The very last bats, the last inning of the game, and your team's ahead. Your team's ahead by one run. You may be in right field, you may be on second base, but your team's ahead by one run. The other team's back. The bases are loaded. There's two outs. The count on the batter's 3-2. Are you with me up to there? The count on the batter's 3-2. The bases are loaded. You're on second base, or right field, or third base, or the pitcher. You may be standing out in left field. The count's 3-2. You're pounding your glove. The ball's on the way to the batter. And are you pounding your glove saying, man, please don't let them hit me the ball. All of us are a little afraid. Please don't let them hit me the ball. Because if I muff it up, we lose the game. Please don't let them hit me the ball. If you stand there in life, stand there saying, please don't let them hit me the ball, in my opinion, you'll never be out. You have to make yourself believe, I want the ball. Hit me the ball. I'll make the ball. The count's 3-2. I want the ball. Hit me the ball, and I'll make the play. Now, in all honesty, we all have the ball hit at us from time to time, and we screw it up. But you have got to believe you can do it. These great people here, this great institution, your Father and God above, has given you the chance to want the ball. Want to all. Counts 3-2. God bless all of you. I'm really proud of every one of you. Thank you.